Hey guys, I'm Nate. I've been jump roping for over 10 years. I know that's a long time. It's been really fun the entire time. I am now a jump rope coach and a jump rope athlete. I've competed across the nation. I have jump rope friends across the world, and I spend a lot of my time training different skills and helping other people learn jump rope. I'm really excited to work with you guys. Hey guys, I'm Nate. We're gonna do a couple of warm-ups real quick before we get into some jumping. So let's start with an easy run in place. Nice and easy. Nice and relaxed, just like you're going down the street to your friend's house, just chilling. But let's go a little bit faster now. Let's go a little bit faster. So we're moving kind of quick. Let's keep that up. And now let's go even faster than that. Can you go even faster than that? How fast can you go? Let's go even faster. Really go, really go, really go. You're running in place. You're running in place. Nice, and big jump and stop. Okay, let's do some jumping jacks. So start with your feet together, hands by your side, and then one big jumping jack, boom, open, and then go right back to the middle, and let's go nice and continuous. Big jumping jacks, big jumping jacks. Make sure your arms are going out real wide, real tall. When you do your jumping jack, reach up super high. Super high. Nice job. Keep going. Keep going. Very good. Very good. Awesome. And come down. Just relax for a second. Let's put our arms out very wide. And then let's put our feet out a little bit wide. And let's turn. Turn to the other side. Turn to the other side. If you can, try to look forwards. Try to look forwards. Don't go too crazy, but make sure that you're twisting around and you're getting real, real loose and having lots of fun. Keep twisting. There you go. Nice, keep going, keep going. All right, let's take our arms and put them out in front of us. Drop one hand to our side and start moving one arm forward. Big circle, big circle. Nice job. Good, and switch to the other side. Big circle with the other side. Nice, there you go. Keep going, keep going. All right, both arms out. And now we're gonna start swimming backwards. Start swimming backwards. Go a little bit faster. There you go. You're backwards swimming now. This one's a little bit tricky, so you gotta pay attention to what your arms are doing. Make sure it's like backwards swimming. Good job. Nice. And relax your arms. Put one arm across your chest. Hold it with the other arm and stretch out that arm. Good job. Make sure you're taking really big, deep breaths. Big breath in and out. Nice job. Okay, let's switch to the other arm now. Same thing on the other side. Hold it there. Take a big breath in and out. Nice, hold it just a little bit longer. Great job. Okay, now let's bring our feet together, face the side, and let's reach as far down as we can to touch our toes. If you can't touch your toes, that's okay. Just go as far down as you can and hold it there. And now we're going to try to touch our toes and come back up. So touch your toes and up and pause right there. Let's keep trying to touch our toes and pulse up and down. Just like I'm doing right here, up and down, up and down. Nice job, nice job. And if you can try to touch the ground. If not, that's okay. But if you can, try to touch the ground. If not, just touch your toes up and down. Make sure you keep those knees straight. Make sure your legs are completely straight. All right. And come back. Now from here, we're gonna put our feet out really wide. Really, really, really wide. Look at where my feet are, they're really wide. And we're gonna reach down to the left side and then to the middle and then to the right. And go all the way back to the beginning. Touch your left toe, touch the middle, touch the right. Let's go a little bit faster. Left, middle, right, left, middle, right, a little faster. Left, middle, right, left, middle, right, left, middle, right. Now pause, wait here. Take both of your hands and touch both of your toes at the same time. Pause right there. Nice, keep holding that position. Now touch the middle. If you can, try to get your hands all the way on the ground and make sure your knees are straight. Keep those knees straight. Okay, nice job. Now let's sit on the ground, put our feet together, have our knees out wide, and we're gonna be a butterfly. So let's take those knees and go up and down. Flap your knees the same way a butterfly flies. This one's called butterfly, so we're gonna keep flapping our knees. Good job. Make sure that your feet are together and you can hold on to your toes while you do this one. Good job. Good job. Keep doing that. Keep moving around. Very nice. Very nice. Okay, now we're gonna come back up. Stand up. This is the last one we're gonna do here. It's called inchworm. So we're going to stand with our feet together. We're gonna touch our toes and then walk them out like an inchworm. So touch your toe, walk forward on the ground, go out to a push-up position, and then walk your toes to your hands and stand up, take a step back. So we're gonna do the exact same thing. Touch your toes, walk your hands out in front of you in a push-up position, then bring your feet to your hands and stand up. Let's do one more. We're gonna do one more inchworm. So feet together, touch your toes, walk your hands out in front of you, and then bring your feet to your hands and stand up. Okay, great job getting all warmed up for some jumping. Hey guys, we're gonna go through five different skills you can learn. We're gonna focus on some power skills, some inversion skills, and kind of do a bunch of cool things. So let's start with a skill called the bubble. It's called the bubble because we're basically gonna make a bubble around our body. So start with putting your left hand down by your thigh and put your other hand, your right hand, up in the air. And we're gonna start by practicing how to wrap the rope around our body. If you notice, I'm just moving with my right hand, the rope goes around my body, just like that. And so instead of a normal jump rope rotation, we're doing it kind of sideways, right? So now we're gonna take our left hand and we're gonna put it in front of our body, right in the middle. And what we're gonna do is the exact same motion, bringing the rope around, we're gonna move it to the left of our body. And as we do that, we're gonna lift up our left leg and the rope is gonna go underneath. Now, watch real closely because it's about to get real crazy, all right? So hand goes down, our right hand goes up in the air, and we're gonna lift up our left leg and bring the rope underneath just like that. So that makes sense, right? So we're gonna do it one more time. Left hand goes down, right hand goes up. We're gonna bring our left leg up. We're gonna bring the rope underneath. And when the rope comes around, we're gonna lift up our other leg and let the rope come out. So all together, we're gonna lift our left leg, then lift our right leg in a row. So the rope comes around, lift your left leg, lift your right leg, and the rope is now back around. So if you've got this part, guess what? You can just keep going. You can just keep going and make a bubble around your body. So the rope's gonna come around, lift your left leg, lift your right leg, and then left, right. And now you can do a bubble around your body. How cool is that? It's pretty cool, right? That's why it's called a bubble, because you're literally making a giant bubble around your body, which is super cool. Let's move on to the seated jump. Obviously, most of the time when we jump on our feet, right? We all know that. But what's even cooler is when we can sit down on the ground and jump. Stay with me. This is going to be really cool. We're going to sit down. We're going to put our feet together. Our feet are totally together. You might hear the rope snap in the wall, but that's okay. We'll still get it done. Feet together, legs are straight. We're going to spin the rope above our head, and it's going to spin towards our feet. So if we're using our right hand, we're going to spin it to our left, just like this. And then what's going to happen is we're going to use our stomach muscles, our abs. We're going to get them real strong, and we're going to lift our feet up. We're going to lift our heels and then our whole body and get up off the ground to go over the rope. So when we go over it, our hand will come down next to our leg. So we're going to lift up our body, and our hand will come down to the ground to help us do a jump. So watch this real close. We spin, and we lift our legs, and the rope goes all the way around just like that. Let's do it one more time. So this rope is spinning to our left. We lift our heels and jump. And then we can keep spinning it above our head. So that is how you do a seated jump. Pretty cool, I know. All right, let's move on to another skill. It's the push-up. Now, the biggest thing to know when we do push-ups with jump rope is we're not going to do a full push-up. Usually, when we do our push-ups, we go all the way down and back up, except we're not gonna do that this time. So without the rope, let's walk through the way a basic push-up go. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna pretend to do a jump, so we can jump, and then we're gonna do a squat, bend our knees, get really close to the ground, and then we're gonna go out into a push-up, and then we're gonna go back into a squat, and then we come back up like we're jumping. So let's do the whole thing together, but let's do it a little bit quicker. So we'll do some jumps, and when I say go, we'll go down to the first squat, then the push-up, then the squat. So ready, set, go. Squat, push-up, squat, and back up to jumping. Cool, that's it. Let's grab the rope. And when we do this, we're gonna do the exact same thing, but we're gonna make sure when we do that squat, our hands get super close to the ground. So I'm gonna count ready, set, go. And then when I say go, squat, hands close to the ground, push up, squat, and then up. So here we go. Start jumping. Ready, set, go. Squat, push up, squat, up. And you pull the rope underneath. Nice job. Let's do it one more time. Okay, one more time, make sure you really got it. So do some jumps. And then ready, set, go. Squat, push up, squat, up. Nice. Okay, if that's super easy, if you know you can do that, if you're making sure your body is straight and it's not all bent like a frog, if you can do it super easy, you can try pulling the rope through at the very end. So I'm gonna show it to you real quick. It's a little bit different than the basic push-up. So we do the same squat, we go out to a push-up, and then we pull it all the way underneath our feet. Just like that. So only do this if you're really comfortable with the basic push-up, okay? Remember, with both of those, it's a squat, push up, squat, up. Nice. Okay, we've got the push up. Let's talk about handstands. Now, you're only going to do handstands if you're a gymnast and you're super duper comfortable with handstands. If you already know how to do a handstand, then you can give this a shot. If you don't know how to do a handstand, don't do this. Don't do this if you can't do a handstand. Yeah, okay? For those of you that are going to gymnastics and you know how to do a handstand, we can try it out with the rope. So it's going to be very similar to your normal handstand. The difference will be that instead of bringing our legs up really straight and then coming back down, once we kick up and we go into the handstand, we're gonna bend our knees and then kick back down, okay? So before we get to that bend and kick, we wanna just start by seeing what it's like to hold the jump rope during a handstand. So we can jump and then do a step into a handstand like you normally would. So jumping, ready, set, go, step. Handstand, step down, and keep jumping. So very, very similar to what you're already used to with a handstand, but it's good to practice what it feels like. Now, once you've done that a bunch of times, once you're feeling really comfortable with the handstand, with the jump rope in your hands, we can add in the bend and kick motion. So it's very similar to what we're already doing, but this time, instead of keeping our legs straight, we're gonna bend our knees, kick off the ground, and actually try to get the rope underneath our legs. So I'll show it to you right here. So ready, set, go, step, kick, bend, pull. And so we're actually gonna try to pull it through coming out of the handstand. Now again, only do this if you're really comfortable with handstands and doing a basic handstand, just kicking up and coming back down is really, really, really easy, okay? But those are some tips to actually try doing a handstand with a jump rope if you're already super comfortable. Cool. So let's move on to the last skill we're gonna talk about, and that's a cartwheel. Again, only do this cartwheel if you're already doing cartwheels, if you're already very comfortable and you've done them a lot in gymnastics. This is going to be very similar to a standard cartwheel. We're just gonna be holding a jump rope and we're gonna finish a little differently. So I'm gonna walk it through real quick and then we'll kind of give it a shot. So we're gonna start it very similar to a handstand. We'll start jumping, go ready, set, go. And when we say go, we'll bring our feet apart, we'll reach and do the cartwheel, we'll go all the way across, and when we land, we're actually gonna, the rope will be in front of our body, and we'll pull it backwards into some backwards jumping. Okay, does that make sense? I'll walk it through one more time. So we'll do ready, set, go, step, go into the cartwheel just like you normally would, and when we finish, we'll pull the rope and go backwards. Okay, so let's give that a shot. Again, we're only doing this if you're already very comfortable with cartwheels. So we'll go, I might have to back up a little bit. So we'll go ready, set, go, step, cartwheel, and then bring the rope backwards and jump, okay? Make sure you have plenty of room to do this one. So it's very similar to your normal cartwheel. So those are 5 different jump rope skills that are powerful. They involve inversion. Those are 5 different skills that you can do with the jump rope. All right, great job, guys. Keep practicing and you'll get very, very, very good.
Hi guys, I'm Michaela. I have been jump roping with the Cornell Speed Spinners for about 10 years, and then I am now an instructor with USA Jump Stars. I've been doing that for about 4 years. I absolutely love it. I love the sport. I love how great you feel after you're done jumping, how you can be around your friends, and just how awesome it is overall. I was a judge at one of the competitions that we went to up in Los Angeles. I also was able to do a lot of the competitions as well with some of my best friends. It's been totally awesome. I know a lot about the sport, and I'm super excited to share what I know with you guys. Hi guys, my name is Michaela, and we're going to go ahead and do a song workout. The song is Baby by Justin Bieber. Just a little background. My favorite song, my favorite artist, and I actually met him like 4 years ago. So we're going to go ahead and jump forwards. And every time you hear him say baby, baby, you're going to stop and go backwards. And then when he does it again and you're backwards, stop and go forward. And then just keep doing it every time you hear that section of the baby, baby. Okay, go ahead and start with the ropes behind your feet and let's get started.
Oh, 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 you know you love me.
Compared to my baby, and nobody came between us, no could ever come above. She had me going crazy, oh, I was starstruck. She woke me up daily, don't need no Starbucks. She made my heart pound and skip a beat when I see her in the street and at school on the playground. But I really wanna see her on the weekend. She knows she got me dazing, cause she was so amazing. And now my heart is breaking, but I just keep on saying,
baby, 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 oh.
catch your breath, get a drink of water, high five each other through the camera. You guys did a great job, and thank you for joining me to do a workout with my favorite artist and my favorite song.